Hello, everyone. Nice to come here to share some experience about Kubernetes operation. As you see from the topic, we will bring you some cases about what we should do when workload is down. And in summary, we conclude from how to recover healthy node. This topic partly based on community project and partly based on our further advanced improvement. Now, I want to introduce us firstly, my partner Dixu from Ant Group, and Xiaoyu Zhang from Tencent Cloud. Both of us are Kubernetes member and very active in community contribution. We always try to use the latest cloud native technology in our work. Here is our agenda. Firstly, we will introduce a common case, which is not ready node. Then introduce an open source project to find the reason. Its name is NPD, short for Node Problem Detector. Besides, we also introduced a new system we called Node Self-Healing. By using those tools, we would want to share some lesson we learned and start some discuss. At last, draw a conclusion of this topic. When you discover the terminal shoe, the node is not ready like this picture, what should we do next? To deal with this, we should firstly make the reason of node problem visible by some ways like checking node status, logs, metrics, and then try to remedy those bad nodes and make the node ready again. But how to make the problem visible quickly? Here we introduce a community project NPD. It deploys as demo agent in every node and report detected result periodically. Node problem is reported as node condition or event. Node condition is permit problem mark the node unavailable, such as kernel deadlock, docker, bad disk. Event is temporary problem but informative, such as OM queued. Only detecting problem cannot meet our satisfaction. We want to fix a healthy node as soon as possible. We need other operators alongside with NPD to help discover and fix problem. Look at the picture we design. We add some components. Node extension is the customer resource definition, which takes place of the native node resource. NPD will report the result to node extension. Config is the map of repair method and problem conditions. Node repair agent has many built-in repair shares. When it watches the node extension conditions on his, it will start self-healing by running specified scripts. But which kinds of problems should be attentioned? Let Dixu share his experience.
Normally, the problems could be varied from hardware to software. Here, we have divided them into below three groups: hardware, system software, runtime. Hardware issues usually include physical disk problem, network issues, disk hull, etc., etc. Here, we have not only list a few common problems. For system software, kernel bug is usually the most frequent one, and log rotate will be another one that records copy stop working due to disk full. In our company, about 6% of the problems are caused by runtime, such as docker, missing runtime socket, etc. This is a configuration YAML for our node problem detector. Actually, this YAML is quite long. I only take part of it. Here we have defined two groups of policies. One is for monitoring Docker. The other is monitoring kernel. Let's deep dive to see some sample plugins. Here we have used prepared checkd, checkfd, binary to periodically check the amount of the d being used. If it exists 8%, a condition will be updated to the node status. Let's see the right picture. Another sample plugin is about inode. This will be quite useful before the system inode gets exhausted, especially when a pod uses host pass volume and creates too many folders by accidentally. Actually, we need to write some remedy scripts to fix these issues when detecting them. But mostly, those remedy scripts are written in shell. Too many corner cases need to be considered. It is very hard to maintain these scripts and keep every fix dependent. The most difficult part will be the complex interdependency. It is hard to split the issues apart, and you have to find out the order, which one is the root cause, and which one should be resolved first. Here I want to have some discussions for the deployment of the detector and the repairing agent. Normally there are two ways. One is through IPM or Debian packages, the other is using daemon set. We can't say which one is best, but in our practice, we use daemon set by considering the upgrading effort. Since the repairing scripts and the detecting plugin will be changed frequently, it is hard to have a static strategy to manage this. And we use config map to start our strategies as well. The last one is a resource overheads about MPD. If you have included too many plugins in your agent, please limit the resource of your daemon set pod. Actually, in the community, Planet Labs have open sourced a project named Rhino, which will automatically condom and join Kubernetes nodes based on node conditions. You can set a configurable join buffer time, and the Rhino will automatically evict the pods one by one. It is very safe. You can see the below events. Here is what we want to address in our session last. Actually, the repairing scripts are not universally valid in any infrastructure. That's why we have not taken too much time on how we fix the issues. There is no silver bullet to fix the node, as you know. You need to have your own secret manual. The most important rule we have got is KISS. Keep your infrastructure simple and standard. It will be much more convenient to fix your nodes. Thanks for coming to our session. Feel free to ping us on Slack.